Use here at a 1-on-4. That's a nice find right through the smoke. Classic JW. And another one, a second. So he's brought it into a 1-on-2. This is actually
chilling in the pit for the time being. He's only on 32 health. Up close and personal, JW will get the
kind of going to play.
Oh, it's cool to see the MAC-10 just rushing right up through the Molotov, and Nico's all alone. And that's flush out with a third. Great job of getting this banana control. Part of it helps. I think Nico's been playing it very passive. There's
found
a good
him quite yet. Surely Golden would know that, but Guardian wants to get aggressive, and there's a good flick over. Nico.
But Karrigan's joined him now. Quad to Arches. Hasn't spotted anyone just yet.
Oh, he got full blind, but timing wasn't there for the hit. There's the peak. That's the bomb down. A flashbang comes out off the wall. He's going to get the angle and a second. This is
clear. Have such little information. Crims has got a kill, though. He's looking for a second one as well. But Rain and Guardian hold. He's going to force out a rotation now from the CTs. Flasher backs away into the smoke. There's going to be Rain taking control and dispatching of both gold. And it's not going to be able to punish them afterwards. 2-1-2.
Take the fight and hope Nico wins him. I don't think he's going to expect the boost here, but it reacts perfectly. Flusha, how passive is he going to play it? Not passive at all. That opens up the sight, and JW's so low,
it's going
down. Nico has made this doable, and he got the third.
Smoke in the hands of Fnatic. They can't cordon off new boxes for Emo with a Molotov.
Going to go down. That could definitely give them a bit of hope, but Guardian's going to snuff that out.
And a second kill onto JW. It's a 1v1, but as you highlighted, no kit. They're going to have to stick on it right here, right now, and Guardian knows it. He's going to be coming around the corner, and that's all she wrote.
That Faze. Actually, on three, there's been no trades until just now. Olaf's Karrigan even chiming in, and there it is, I think.
Olaf might be here around the corner, crosshair a little bit too low. That'll cost him his life. Karrigan's going to drop and take him out of the equation, but in the meantime, Guardian has been put in his place, and Karrigan 1-on-3 with 15 seconds and just 17 health. This is almost as hard as it gets. Surely there's no chance in Crims.
3-on-5, now this one, picking off JW. The hit is on, but Crims has a great off angle. Oh, he covers Lecro perfectly. Vintage Crims. Oh, they don't clear it. There's one, there's two. Crims again, almost closes it out.
Karrigan can hear footsteps, the pitter-patter of JW just to his left-hand side. That smoke is going to pretty much force him out into the open. He can't afford to take any chances himself, but there's the spray onto JW now this round. Firmly in the hands of Karrigan. He comes back through again and will clutch out to keep Faze.
He's point of contact next. This has got to be an instant headshot. It is. It's two. How has he done that?
On this side, Lecro, fair enough. He's got himself a couple kills. Flushes came in with one as well. What the hell's happening here, Faze? You can't let this happen. But Karrigan with a double spray. He's going to leave up to Rain, who has the perfect spray transfer. One health.
Side. They try and hit A. They get made. Just has to sit there and wait.
And there's JW for another
took them down into this position in the first place. And down goes Rain. 17.